picture my Aunt Sharon. Well, I thought she was my aunt when I thought I was a crane. She died last year.
Sheridan Crane. I remember hearing something about that.
Still hard to believe. Sheridan was special. So beautiful. Everyone loved her.
There's a picture of a beautiful woman in my wallet. My fiancée, Diana.
Alistair's call?
Yes. You remember our little problem with Luis and Sharon?
Yeah, you were concerned that if Luis and Sheridan got married, Luis would start digging into all the Crane family secrets.
This is why we had to split them up, yeah?
Yeah, I don't know exactly what you're trying to hide, but it must be pretty major for you to have your own sister killed.
Oh, child. Trust me, it is. It seems that Sheridan didn't die after all.
What?
Sheridan is alive.
First Teresa, and now Sheridan? Doesn't anybody stay dead in this town? Oh, there's something in the water.
It seems that Sheridan is poolside with Luis as we speak, making up all the bedtime they lost together.
Well, what are you going to do?
I'm going to make sure that Luis dies tonight as well as his brother, Antonio.
I can't believe you're here. In my arms. I love you.
I love you so much.
I miss you so much. I'm never gonna let you go. And I'm never gonna let anything come between us again.
What's happening? What's wrong with Charity?
Her body is reacting to going off life support. She's safe enough.
Charity, don't leave me. Please don't die.
It's in God's hands now. Come.
How difficult this is for all of you. All I can tell you is that you've done the right thing.
What happens now?
We wait. Charity's heart will just get weaker and weaker, and eventually it will stop. But I can assure you that Charity will go into you.
No! I won't let her go.
Charity,
you can't die. You can't.
I would hold the hand of the one who could lead me places, and kiss the lips of the one who seems so insane.
To get rid of Luis, but why Antonio? I mean, what does he have to do with Sheridan?
According to Pop, Sheridan has been living with Antonio on a remote island near Bermuda since the boat exploded. It seems she had amnesia. She thought she was engaged to Luis, fell in love with Antonio, and now she's his fiancée as well.
Wow. This is unbelievable.
It gets better than that. Since leaving Harmony, Antonio has been going by the name of Brian O'Leary. No, Sheridan simply was Diana.
All because Sheridan forgot who she is.
Until seeing Luis made her remember her past, seemingly with the exception of the time she spent with Antonia.
Wow. You know, this southern was just amazing. What's romantic? I mean, just thinking of those two handsome, virile young men with bodies to die for.
Do you mind?
Sorry. Well, it is quite an explosive situation, isn't it?
Well, it's a recipe for disaster, which is why I was looking for Antonio. You see, it won't be long now before Luis and Sheridan return to her cottage, which is where I will send Antonio to find his Diana in the arms of his brother.
Oh, and he'll want to kill Luis.
And vice versa, since Luis already hates his brother.
That picture of my fiance in my luggage. I'll show it to you later, though. So let's see that picture of your aunt. One second, my nephew's calling.
Sheridan, is anything to have you back? That'll take a miracle.
Wonderful to see you with him. And to have you back in the family again.
Yeah, I'm here to stay. Diana and I, we're going to make our life here in Harmony together. I cannot wait for you to meet her. And I can't wait for the rest of the family to meet her, too.
Well, I am sure that we're going to love her. It's obvious that you do.
More than anything in the world. Diana's my life.
That's why I love you, Tim.
How could you stand to lose her? I know if anyone tried to take Diana away from me, they could kill her.
This is going to work out perfectly.
You shouldn't have worn a boomer so far. It's in with.
Hey, don't you worry about it, right? It'll come. Will you just let me pamper you?
And I would like something to drink.
No. Will you just stay here? Keep looking gorgeous.
I remember where I've been with this whole time.
I'll tell you what, I'm going to go find Luis. Let him know that I never got the note about our house burning down and about you being in trouble. Reassure him that I would have been here sooner if I'd have known.
Hey, I'm sure Luis is not going to be mad when you explain to him what happened.
Luis and I are going to be fine. All of our problems are in the past. There's nothing for us to fight about anymore.
Oh, but there is. Her name is Sheridan.
I'm starting to remember things from the time I was missing.
It's fantastic.
I was with a couple. A man and a woman. We all seemed really happy.
Do you remember their name?
No. But I remember we were on an island. And on a boat.
Yeah, well, that makes perfect sense. We were down in Bermuda when the boat exploded, and well, there are hundreds of little islands down there. Wow. And it sounds like this man and woman must have pulled from the sea. Saved your life.
I guess, but nothing more is coming to me right now, and I can't remember who they are or where they are now.
It's okay. Just give us some time. Everything's going to come to you.
frustrating to not know.
Did you bring the purse?
Back in the cottage, why?
Maybe I can help you figure out who this couple was. All right, I'm gonna get the pool lights. We're gonna head back to the cottage, okay?
Okay. Man and woman a couple? Or does she mean something more to me?
I know that we did the right thing. It's just so hard to see her like this. And Val is devastated.
Yes, he is.
You're gonna be all right, Charity. You hear me? I won't let you die.
What am I going to say? Can I please sit with you outside?
What is it, my child?
I know I'm not in a church, but I need to make a confession.
I know what you're going to confess.
You do.
You gave in to temptation again when I warned you not to. You used the liquid in the vial, Charity's essence, to fool Miguel into making love to you. You embraced evil, Kay.
Yes, but that isn't what caused everything that's gone on here tonight.
Of course it did. If you had not cast the spell that froze Charity, her zombie would never have been created. But she was frozen. And now she's dying because of it.
But I just... I never meant for it to get this out of control.
Look at the damage you have done, Kay. Look at the pain you have caused. You and your evil.
Go, Mrs. Bennett.
I know it's difficult, Miguel, but you have to.
Right, son. But I love her so much. Charity? She's awake. Charity, you're awake. Thank God.
Yeah. You're in the hospital.
She's gonna be all right now, isn't she?
No. This doesn't change anything. Okay.
Come here, Charity.
I'm not okay.
I don't want to lose you.
You won't lose me. I'll be there. In your heart. Angry. Yes. Thanks for taking care of me. This is my own time. Every moment of it was a gift. I need to talk to
him. Who?
Who do you want to talk to?
She's right outside. I'll go get her.
Sands. Charity.
She's very weak. In case she wants to talk to you.
Me.
Good night. Get some rest, okay?
Okay.
I'll see you tomorrow.
I'm really glad at home.
I'm sorry, sir. I've tried every hotel in town and there's no Diana registered.
Okay. Thanks for checking out. That's funny. I wonder where she could be.
You're about to find out.
What do you want, Trey?
Oh, hey. Did I overhear you say that you were looking for someone at Diana?
What was it? Yeah, what about her?
Well, perhaps I can help you find her.
What are you talking about?
We have this cottage on... you would remember, you stayed there with your family when you were but a child.
Yeah, of course I remember it. You and Alistair kicked us out right after our father disappeared.
Yes, well...
Well, what? Why would my fiancée be there, huh?
Well, I'm not saying that she is. It's just that first-time visitors to the estate many times like to take in as much of it as they can, and perhaps she's... Yet to check into her motel because she's still checking out the ground.
She did have a big reaction when I mentioned that my mother worked for cranes.
There you go. You can check out the cottage if you like. It's no difference to me.
Far so good. I'm not nervous at all.
Yeah, but we're still close to shore. Water's calm. I want to see how you do when we get in the rough stuff. Make sure you're ready for this trip.
By George, I think she's got it.
By George, I think you're right. I can't believe starting tomorrow I won't need you to help keep me from being fired. I'll actually be able to wait tables all by myself and get tips all on my own. Oh, gee, look at that. You missed a spot.
Oh, you think so?
Hey. Hey, why don't you take a look through this?
Yeah.
And see if there are any clues inside or where you've been or who you've been with.
Oh, there's a boarding pass. No name on it, though.
That's no problem. So yeah, I'll just get on the police computer, check into the flight, and see what else we can find out, ma'am.
Thanks.
Hey, don't worry. We're going to put this puzzle together, all right? How are you feeling?
Got a few more memories.
Of the couple you remember before?
Yeah. I can tell they're very nice to me.
Yeah. All right, well, we're going to find out who they are, okay? When we do, I want to personally thank them for taking care of the woman I love.
You are my passion for life.
Hey, I'm glad you're here. I need to talk to you.
What about him?
I need you to look after him. This is going to be really hard for him. You just make sure that he's okay. I know that you're going to take good care of him. I promise I will, Thank
you. I heard what Charity said. She's asking you to take care of Miguel. How you caused all of this to happen. How can you live with this? Thanks for all your help.
I'm just happy that you're all right. And that your baby still has its mommy.
I'm just happy that my son has a man with you in his life. Oh. Good night, Glenn.
Good night, Teresa.
Well, Ethan, I will see you in the morning.
Teresa?
I'm sorry to be such a bother. Would you mind helping me get upstairs?
No, no, of course not.
I could be there to see the fight. All that testosterone being released in a flurry of fists and muscles and sweat.
We'll see the end result. That's all that matters. Both Luis and Antonio will be dead. It's a perfect revenge on the Lopez Fitzgeralds.
I never meant to hurt Charity or Titi. Things have got really out of control, Father. Please, give me absolution.
I'm sorry, King. I cannot absolve you of your sins. Not this time.
I'll get you there. I know this is a lot to ask, but is that anything you could do to fall asleep?
keep having these memories of being in that coffin.
Oh, God, no, of course. Of course you do. Yeah, no, I'd be happy to sit with you and see if I'll see.
Good grief, she's sucking him in again.
When? Gwen, you can't let her get away with that. What am I supposed to do? If I question Teresa Swoon, Ethan will think I'm in a shrew. We've got to do something. Because that little tramp is doing everything she can to get Ethan back.
Yes, I know. I have eyes, Mother.
Gwen, look, I know you're trying to be fair. But what has fair gotten you? Look, you lost Ethan once. I don't want to have to see you lose him again.
Neither do I.
Then get serious. It's time to fight fire. With fire.
Yes, Father. Antonio is on his way to the cottage even as we speak. It won't be long now before all hell breaks loose. Oh, yeah. Poor Pilar. She'll lose two of her sons tonight when Antonio finds Luis in bed with Sheridan. The brothers will kill each other.
Well, there's the cottage. Changed a lot since we lived there. Can't imagine what Dinah would be doing in there, but...
No. All right, here you go. Tonight's flight manifest. Okay, let's check out the passenger list. Wow. Well, that's weird. Sheridan flew to Harmony on the same flight as my brother and his girlfriend Diana.
Hold it, my hand.
You know what? That's fine. But as soon as the race is over, I'm going to pick you out and get your property.
Oh, my God. This man did mean something to me. I was going to marry him. You can't give me absolution?
No, Kay, I cannot.
Well, why not? I mean, I said I was sorry, and I admit what I did was wrong.
What you did went far beyond wrong, Kay. You embraced evil.
But you're a priest. I mean, it's your job to forgive me for that.
I can only grant absolution if I believe you will avoid the same sin in the future and not take advantage of the opportunities your deal with the dark side has left in its wake.
Who are you talking about?
Can you honestly tell me that once Charity is in heaven, you will not try to make Miguel your own?
I'm sorry, Father. I still don't understand what you're saying. I mean, if Miguel is alone and there's no one else here for him, then what would be wrong with the two of us being together?
I am so terribly disappointed in you, Kay.
Why? What did I do this time?
You simply refuse to acknowledge that you are the one responsible for Miguel being alone. If you had not made a deal with the forces of evil, Miguel and Charity would be together now. Perhaps even married, living a happy life. The only possible way I can grant you absolution is if you promise me that before you start any relationship with Miguel, you will tell him everything you have done. Everything, Kay.
Father, if I told Miguel everything I've done, he'd hate me. No, I can't do that.
Then I cannot offer you absolution. All I can do is offer you penance, and it is to tell Miguel the truth. Then, and only then, can I offer you absolution.
Thank you. That's only a possibility. I don't know about the neckline.
You're wasting your time.
So you could say. I love the way you do gloves.
You will never marry Luis.
If you think you're going to spoil this
for me. Well, for starters, you don't deserve him.
I'm not listening.
You are a horrible girl, Beth.
And my mother?
Yes. Yes, that's why I've been praying for Sheridan to come back from the dead. Come back to Harmony.
I'm going to marry Luis. He loves me, and I love him. And you can pray all you want.
Oh, well.
Nothing is going to bring Sheridan back. Okay? She's gone, and I've got Luis. Oh, Lucy.
Blessed angels. Hear my prayer. Bring Sheridan Crane back to life. Send her back to Harmony. Don't let Beth marry Luis. No, sir.
That man. I was going to marry him. And I can't even remember his name. Who is he?
I just had a thought.
I thought we weren't supposed to do any of the thinking stuff until tomorrow. Tonight is just this.
Yeah, but you have done so much for me. You give me a wonderful birthday. Now it's my turn to give back, do something for you.
No, Brian. Brian! His name is Brian, and I was Diana. I remember everything. Oh, God, Luis. What am I going to do? How am I going to tell him that I fell in love with another man while I was missing a man that I'm engaged to marry?
Coincidence. Sheridan flew in on the same flight as Antonio and Diana. Strange, though. Can't find her name on the passenger list.
Sheridan, you're not going to believe this, but...
Hey. What's up? You look like you've seen a ghost. You remember something from the time you were missing? Huh? Where you were? Who you were with? Well, there's the cottage. Not since we lived there. I can't imagine what Diana would be doing in there, but we'll find out.
Knock it off, Mother. Now. Okay, I'm gonna check a couple things online. No wedding. No wedding! No Luis. It's the last thing I do. I will stop it. I will.
Hey, something is definitely wrong. What is it?
It's... Oh, hey, someone sent you an instant message.
All right, it can wait. Someone's bothering you.
It's just that I... You know, I need to think things through. I just have to get my thoughts together. Go check your message while I get my head organized. Really, go on. What are you doing online, future husband?
Where are you?
At home, going through my bridal magazine, starting to plan our wedding.
See you.
Luis is on his way over. So I don't want you going on and on about Sheridan coming back or any other crazy thing you might dream up. It's just going to upset him. You understand?
You can say whatever you want, because nothing is going to stop me. I won't let you marry Luis. I won't let you.
There's nothing you can do about it. Sheridan is dead. Luis is mine. That's just the way it is.
Well, you had better work a miracle here. You better bring Sheridan back to life, back to Luis's life.
Hey. Everything okay?
Yeah. Like I said, I have to put a few things together in my head.
Yeah. A few things I gotta put together myself. Yeah.
You leaving?
Well, yeah, I got something kind of important I take care of.
Everything all right?
Yeah, everything's fine. I have to go talk to someone, and then, then I'll come back, and you and I'll sit down, and we'll have a nice talk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There's just a few things I need to tell you.
Yeah, just a few things I need to tell you, too.
Okay. Time to see if Diana's here.
He's the new boss.
I'm Dylan.
Nice to meet you.
Boink means?
Yeah, it's what you're not doing. I got it.
Oh. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to boink you on the head there.
The expression's bonk.
Bonk, right.
From the creators of...